Alright guys, Samsung has launched its new foldable device 2 weeks ago online. So it is the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 and also the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 3. I've loaned a unit of the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 last week here with me. So it actually claims that this series of phone is the first ever water resistance foldable phones in the market up to date, and it also is the first one who have the in-display camera in its foldable devices. I've heard that they has also improved the hardware, which is best for a productivity phones. So today I would like to share with you about the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 specifications and also some of my reviews on these phones after using it for 1 week. So without further ado, let's go. I've got this phone as a loan unit. I do not have the box with me. So this time we are going to skip the boring unboxing time for this series. So let's proceed with the reviews on this Samsung Galaxy Z Fold. If you can see on my hand here, on the first glance, I felt that this phone is quite similar with the predecessors, the Galaxy Z Fold 2. I do not see any difference on a first glance on this, but once I've got hold on this phone, I felt that the phone feeling is really really good. This is the first thing that I've realized. The second thing is this side of this frame, the phone frame here, it is equipped with the armor aluminium, which is 10% more durable than the Fold 2, which goes same to the back here. You can see the back here, right, is quite a bit of matte feeling that we can get on this Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3, which is good where it actually reduces the fingerprint stain on it. This phone, if you put it unfold like this, is 2mm thinner than its predecessor, the Fold 2. It feels like a proper tablets when I hold it on hand like this unfold. It has the micro nano SIM and also eSIM on this, together with a micro SD slot. And as what I've mentioned earlier, this is the IPX8 water resistant foldable phones, which is the first in the market to have the water resistant, but it is not dust resistant though. On the side here, you have the volume up and down, and also the power on and off with a fingerprint sensor on it. This phone has two speakers, one on the bottom and one on the top here, which is a stereo speaker tuned by AKG. It has the USB-C charging port on the bottom here, and it is stylus support too. Just bear in mind that the stylus that supports or compatible with this Samsung Galaxy Z Fold is the Fold S Pen and also the S Pen Pro. Others, they are not compatible with this. And this Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 has also the Samsung Dex feature on it. It is 271 grams, which is about 11 grams lighter than the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 2. As for the screen here, when you see on the front screen, so this is the front screen, it is equipped with the Gorilla Glass Victor screen, which is 50% more durable on all these pressure that we are going to apply in it when we drop on it. It is also equipped with the dynamic AMO LED with 120 Hz of refresh rate for smooth and fast scrolling. It also has the 1200 nits pix, which is 35% brighter than its predecessor too. This screen is 6.2 inch with 1768 x 2208 pixels. While we unfold on it, this screen here is equipped with the dynamic AMO LED, 120 Hz of refresh rate as well. But they have the Corning Gorilla Glass Victus on this. It is 7.6 inch with 832 x 2268 pixels. You can see all these connecting lines, right? It is much more less obvious compared to the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 2. On the layers here, it has the TEP protective screen, which is 80% more durable than the Z Fold 2. So this is really, really good, especially for me. Sometimes I'm quite careless and I'm really, really worried that I will break this foldable device, and this is not cheap though. So as for the camera here, we have three sides of camera. One is on the back, one is on the front selfie, and another one is the in-display camera, which they highly shout out on. So let's start with the back camera here. This back camera, they have 12 megapixel f1.8 26mm wide IOS, 12 megapixel f2.4 52mm telephoto lens, and 12 megapixel f2.2 125 degree 12mm ultra wide angle. It allows 4% more lights into the lens itself, which makes your photos brighter than ever. So as for videos, this back camera is equipped with the 4K at 60fps, 1080p at 60 or 240fps, and for slow-mo or cinematic moves, you can also opt for the 720p at 960fps. The best thing about this is the ability to use the back camera for selfie or videos. This feature is really, really underrated for this phone. I like it because you can actually view yourself on the front screen while capturing it on the back screen like this. So let me show you how this camera works. So if I want to take any photos, this view will show you how the camera looks like. So now let's talk about the selfie camera, the front selfie camera here. This front selfie camera is not that great. It is only equipped with a 4 megapixel f1.8 lens, and it could only snap 4K at 30fps or 1080p at 30fps. While this internal in-display, which you can see from here, you can see the round color thing. This is on the in-display here. It is equipped with the 10 megapixel f2.2 26mm wide lens, and it also, of course, only could shoot 4K at 30fps and 1080p at 30fps. Even though this under display is not as good as the back display here, I believe that we will seldom use this under display camera whenever we go out. Since they have the in-display camera here, most probably because of we have the flex mode, and it is really suitable for us to zoom meeting calls or maybe FaceTime with other people. So now let me show you some of the photos and also videos that I've captured with this phone through the back, front, and also in-display camera. Thank you.
Hi guys, this is the back camera I'm using now at a 0.6 time zoom, and currently I'm going to zoom to 1x. This is the 1x zoom, 2x zoom, and then we have even more that we can zoom to 4x, and then 10x zoom. This is the max that we can go on to.
Alright guys, currently I'm using the outside front selfie camera to record this video. Basically, there's no zooming in and zooming out. This is the 1x zoom. And now I'm using the camera on the inner side. As usual, it's same as the front selfie camera. There's no way for us to zoom in and zoom out. So basically, this is how it looks like on the 1x zoom.
Alright guys, I'm holding the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3, and currently I'm recording this video with the back camera. So this is with the 0.6x zoom view, and now let's zoom to 1x zoom. This is how it looks like. You see, when we zoom in, it looks much more brighter with the 1x zoom view. And if we go into second zoom, it will be like this. As you can see, it is not really clear, especially when we are recording this at night. You see, there's a lot of the blurness on the images here, but no worries. Let's move to the front selfie camera and see how it looks like on the front selfie camera. Alright guys, currently I've switched to the inner camera of the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3. As you can see from this camera, the video is not really good. So you can see the blurness on my face and also my background. So I believe that if you want to use this inner self camera, let's stick to the zoom meeting calls and all those. Oh yeah guys, I've forgotten about this. I'm using the back camera to record this selfie video. So this video looks better than the selfie camera quality.
Alright, if you see from the photos and also videos that I've taken with this phone, the quality of the photos is quite decent. You have some good pictures with some good details on the photo itself, especially for the back camera. They have also the mic mode SIM optimizer for these cameras too, which helps a lot on the photos at night, but it is not impressive. Anyway, this phone's camera is meant to be used for a basic use. It is not meant for the professional photographers or videographers use. As for the features of these phones, there are a few features that I like the most about this phone. One is the flex mode phone, where you could actually hands-free and take photos with it. So you can actually sit down here and use the ins display to take some photos, or you can use the back display to take some of your front photos. You can also even use this to take your own photos, but of course if you use the flex mode, you couldn't see the screen unless you are holding like this with the screen on the bottom here. This hands-free feature with the screen preview is really useful for me and for all those basic users which they could not gauge how wide the photo would be if they take the selfie with this. And this flex mode combined with the auto framing, it could actually zoom in and out as people move around. So when you move around, the lens will help you to actually auto adjust it. Even if you have a lot of people in a single photo, they could adjust the lens accordingly. So they will actually move it into a wide angle lens and capture the whole group in that particular photos. The director's view is one of the premium features that is available in their recent Galaxy S21 series, but they have incorporated these features into this Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3. I've taken a director's view videos sample and this is how it looks like. Alright guys, currently I'm holding the Samsung Z Fold 3 here and I'm using the director's view feature. You can see in front of me here, this shop lot. Currently I'm using the 0.6 time zoom and you can actually change the length of the video into one time zoom like this or two time zoom into like this. But as when you change to this mode, when I'm in my selfie mode, I couldn't actually zoom in or out. It's just one time zoom angle. The drag and split feature is also a really good feature to have in this phone. You could drag to the right to open the details in a new window while keeping the old windows active on the left side. As for performance, this Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 is equipped with the Qualcomm SM8350 Snapdragon 888 5G. It also equips with the 12GB of RAM for fast processor. Basically, with this feature, the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 is an excellent performer. I've tried to play my Elsfart games with it and I've never felt any lag with it before. And while I was like working with multiple tabs of Google Chrome, I've also tried to play a YouTube video while working with it and it is awesome. The responsiveness is really really fast. So how about the battery life of this Samsung Galaxy Z Fold, since they have a so big screen on it, right? It is equipped with the 4400 mAh with 25W of fast charging, 11W of wireless fast charging and also 4.5W of reverse wireless charging. Of course, the wireless charging is quite slow compared to the others. Anyway, it is a good feature to have in a phone. So overall, I felt that this Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 is one of the few devices in the market that I would really highly recommend if you are looking for one foldable phone. The under display is for mostly an interrupt view experience. It has a great battery life even though it is only 4400 mAh. Which this phone right could last me for more than a day of use. Of course, a normal use, not a heavy user use in a single charge, you see. So it is really durable. I felt that it is really solid and the most important is it is IPX8 water resistant. It comes with three colors, the Phantom Black, Phantom White and also Phantom Green. At first, I felt that this is the Phantom Black color series, but they told me that this is the Phantom Green. If you never look properly, right, you really didn't realize that this phone is Phantom Green phone. This Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 price starts from 6,999 for the 256GB internal storage. Basically, I felt that this Samsung Galaxy Z Fold phone is suitable for those who are looking for a foldable device that could help to boost your productivity, such as business people, maybe those who love large screen. You know, some of them, they would like to have large screens to work with, and maybe those who would like to use the S Pen as well. So I think that's all folks for my sharing and review on this Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3. I hope you like what I've shared with you in this video. If you like my video, please do press the subscribe button if you haven't already done so. And also hit the notification bell to receive my upcoming video. Oh yeah, by the way, next week I'm going to share with you my reviews on the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 3. So thanks for watching and I'll see you in my next video.